putting Rare Beauty to the test. Please excuse my appearance. I'm babbling. I'm just kidding. No. We're gonna see if Rare Beauty can fix this. I wanna look like Selena Gomez. We're gonna see if it's good for colored skin. I've been seeing a lot of people doing reviews. Don't see a lot of colored people or of different color tones. At least I haven't seen it in my YouTube algorithm. I'm not saying there aren't people doing it, but I thought I'd give it a go. I did not get a PR package sent to me. I had to go buy these things myself. It's not a problem, but because I had to buy it myself, I only could afford certain things. Watch my videos so I can afford to buy the whole line. I'm just kidding. I'm kidding, but not really. So I only have a couple of things that really caught my eye about the Rare Beauty. I got the foundation in 41ON. I got the concealer in 41ON, which is pretty much matching the foundation. And the most exciting product that I picked up that I really, really wanted to try were the blushes. I picked it up in two different colors because, well, the more the merrier. I picked up the infamous, the infamous Love blush, the Love. It's like a nice terracotta color. So I picked it up in this color. And because sometimes I like a lighter blush, I also picked up Bliss, Selena's actual favorite blush. She actually really likes this one. I also saw James Charles put it on and I thought it looked amazing. Let's get to it. Let's just do our makeup. Go to my brows off camera and I'll be right back. Okay, I went a little overboard with my eyebrows. I'm just having a really bad eyebrow day. It turns out 2020 is just on a downward spiral. So let's start off by using the Rare Beauty foundation. I think you shake it. Let's hope this shade match that I did works out. Ooh, it's very runny. I usually don't like runny foundations. It's really runny. But I like the Doe Foot applicator. I think it's cute. But yeah, it's really runny. See if it matches. It's a bit orangier than my skin. So I guess put it. I'm gonna put it everywhere. So, okay, now I'm gonna take my LA Pro Color Girl Mixing Foundation Pigment, and I'm just gonna dab it all over the skin. I use blue because I'm olive tone, so I need to balance the oranginess out. To a very nice matte satin finish. I'm astounded. A really beautiful satin natural matte finish. Almost. I'm impressed. So I'm gonna go with the concealer, the Rare Beauty, the Rare Beauty concealer. Put it into the areas I would usually put concealer. Oh, that's really orangey toned. Okay. Maybe I should have picked up a lighter color because to highlight with. I guess this would be a good color correcting. It's hard because I couldn't swatch anything because of COVID.
It feels like maize in my hair. In maize on my face.
But we'll see what it feels like when we blend it out.
Final thoughts
on the concealer. I don't like it. Not doing it for me. I need more coverage. If you're like Emma Chamberlain or Emma Chamberlain, who are naturally pretty and don't really need makeup that much, or Selena Gomez herself, you know, if you're naturally that gorgeous, you don't need reconstructive surgery or more coverage. I would say it's a good concealer. Those of us who need to hide our dark circles and blemishes and, you know, catfish, we need something more brightening. So I'm gonna go in and use a brightening concealer, Pat McGrath concealer in M18. The Skin Fetish Sublime Concealer. This one really does have like that coverage, and considering the owner of Pat McGrath is of color, she definitely understands that our dark circles are not easily covered. Okay, so now that I have my concealer down, let's try out the new Laura Mercier setting powder that they brought out in the shade Honey.
Perfect.
I'm gonna go quickly just bronze up my face. I am baking my nose a little bit, not a lot of bit. Oh my god, it's made in Korea. These are made in Korea. Whoa. The blush. It's in the color Love. So let's do a swatch. That's so pigmented. Are you kidding? Bliss blush. Oh, it's gonna be a little light for my skin. What? Am I seeing this right? You guys, there's a hair in my blush. What the f- There's a hair in the dope with applicator, look! Oh my god, how can I show you? Wait. Look! Oh my god, look right there. Strange. That worrisome. But am I gonna still put on my face? Yes. I don't know how I feel about the whole hair situation, but I'm gonna move past it. Anyways, yeah, these are the two swatches. So I think I'll make a coagulation. I'm gonna mix the two. I'm just gonna put onto my hand like that and then build the coverage, and it makes a nice color like this. It's a very pretty color for a blush. So I'm just gonna smile. So, I like the blush. It's really sweet, cute, buildable. It dried down to like a really matte finish, which is surprising because it's a liquid blush. I'm gonna do my eyes and my lips and the rest of my face, finish up, and then see what the final look looks like. I'll be back. Okay, now that we have our eyes done and lashes and lips, this is the final face base. I see some creasing here. I even said it with Laura Mercier. You know, usually Laura Mercier never fails me. The Rare Beauty seems to be creasing up here a lot. It is what it is, but it's still a nice foundation and concealer. One last thing on camera that I wanted to do was put the blush on my inner lip to, you know, see what it looks like. I'm gonna use the Bliss that I found the hair in. Very weird. I'm just gonna put it in the middle. Blend it out. Now I'm gonna go in with Love. I feel like this would be such a pretty topper. Oh yeah. That's pretty. It's so pretty. This combination of lipstick and whatever. So I'm just gonna spray my face, set my face. Or it's already creasing. I'm not sure if it's the foundation or the concealer, but my favorite part of it all are these two blushes. They're so versatile. You can use them for cheek and lip, two in one. So that's very sweet. But this is the final look. It's cute. I like it. It's nice. Here's a close up. So far so good. I actually like it. I'll check in with you in a bit. Okay, so I added a few more things. So far the foundation is good. It didn't crease too much, but overall it's a very matte look. I didn't love the concealer, but the blushes are amazing. They're still on. So that's great. I would say that, you know, it's okay. But the most exciting part were the blushes, and that's the only thing probably I'll repurchase. Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video. I'll see you in my next video. Like and subscribe.